Hi everyone, in this video we will learn about the scope functions of Kotlin. To make our work easy, Kotlin standard library has many functions to form a temporary scope. We can call these functions from any object. And inside the temporary scope that is formed, we can access the object to perform more operations on that object. There are 5 scope functions available in standard library. And all these functions are very similar in nature because all these functions forms a scope where you can access the object. We can differentiate these scope functions in 2 ways. The first one is how it refers the context object. And the next thing is what is the return value of this scope function. This table here defines how the context object is referred in each function and what is the returned value. As you can see, the first 3 functions let, run, and with returns the lambda result. And the last 2 apply and also returns the context object itself. And inside let and also we can use it, that is the default name given to the lambda argument. But you can also give your custom name if needed. All the other functions refer the context object using this. It means you are inside the object scope and you can refer to the members using this keyword. And if you want, you can also omit the this keyword and you can directly access the members if the context object is referred by this. That means if you are inside run, with, or apply. So one by one, we will see examples of these scope functions. The first one is let. And for the sake of example, I have already created a class here. So we have a class square. We have some properties and we have some functions inside this class. Now we will use this class to explain the scope functions. So we will start with let. Now we can use let to form a temporary scope and inside the scope we can access the object. And this statement is true for all the functions available here. So we will start with let. For example, I have val square and I can create a square that is our class. I will pass width and height and to call the scope function let, I can write a dot here and then let. Now inside this lambda, that is a block of curly braces, a scope is formed. And inside this scope, we can access the square instance that is created. As you can see with the hint here, we can access the object using it keyword. So here I can simply write it dot fill color. Let's say I want to fill red and then it dot add text. And I want to add some text like this. Now, if you want, you can change the name of the argument that is it by default. So here we can simply write any name. Let's say square like this. So now instead of it, you can use square. And as I already shown here, the return value of let function is the lambda result. And it means the last statement that you will write inside this scope is the return value. And it is optional. If you want to use the return value, you can use it. If you don't write anything, that means it is returning unit. So I want to return this square. So what I can do is I can write a square here. And the last statement is the return value. Now, if I will print the square here, I am printing this square. Let's run the code. You can see we are getting these functions called, for example, fill color, red color filled, and then add text, some text, text added. And finally, we are getting the class value, width is 10, height is 20, color is red, and text is some text. Because here I am printing the instance and I have overridden the toString function. So that is why I am getting the string value of the class. So this is what the let function is. And very often we use this let function for null safety or for checking if the value is null. For example, we can create a new square here. Let's say I have let init var square of type square. And inside my main function, I have a null square. Now assume square is coming from somewhere and it can be null. Right now it is null because it is not coming from somewhere, but let's assume it is coming from some other function and it may be null or it may not be null. So in this case, we use let function very frequently. For example, if I want to assign this square, let me change the name square one to this square, then what I can do is I can write here square one let and then square equals to it. So this is how we use the let function very frequently. So this is all for let. Now let's go to run. Run is same as let. It returns the lambda result, but the context object is referred using this and not it. So in case of run, we cannot have a custom name for our argument because it is this and we are inside the scope of the object. So let's see how it works. I will delete everything and this time I will create val square equals to square, the same thing actually, let's say 1020, and then I will use the run function. Now the square is getting referred using this, as you can see with the help of this hint here. So here you can use this dot add text, let's say some text, this dot fill color, let's say blue this time, and finally we can return this because it also returns the lambda result. That means the last statement is the return value and you do not need to write return explicitly. And because it refers the object using this is also not necessary. We can omit the this like this. And if I will print the square, then I will get the same output. You can see it is working fine. So we are done with let and run. Let's use with. Now we use with when we have a lot of functions and properties to call from an object. So what happens is you created an instance and you need to call functions from this instance. Let's say fill color red, square dot add text, my text or anything, and you have a number of functions. Okay, let's say f1 and then you have square dot f2 and you have a lot of functions, let's say 10-20 functions. Now you can simplify the code using with. What you can do is you can pass your object inside with function and it will form a temporary scope where you can refer the object using this. That means you can directly call all the functions and directly access all the members of this square instance without referring the instance again and again and again. And with returns the lambda result. That means the last line is the return value, or if you don't want to use the return value, you can ignore it. It's not necessary. It is optional. So here I can use square dot add text, let's say my text or anything, square dot add color, it is fill color, so let's say yellow or anything. Now I can print the square and I will get the same result. You can see it is working. So we are done with width. Now we have apply. Now it refers the object using this and returns the object itself. So you can simply use apply like this. We have square and then apply. So apply we can use to perform the initial configuration of an object. For example, we created an object and we are applying these changes. For example, I want to fill the color, let's say black, and I want to add the text, black text or anything. And finally, we are printing the square. Here, we do not need to return the square because it returns the context object itself. So here we are getting the square that is modified inside this apply function. Now, if I run the code, I will get the same output. We are getting the function called and we are getting the updated values. Now the last one is also, and it is same as apply, and you can use also as well for initial configuration. The only difference is inside also you will use it to refer the object like this. Run the code and we will get the same output. You can see. So this is how you can use scoped functions. And in case you have any question or confusion, you can leave your comments. I hope you liked this video and learned something. In case you have any suggestion or feedback, you can leave your comments below. And also for any kind of question, don't hesitate to ask by commenting below. So thanks for watching everyone. This is Bilal Khan now signing off.